Hello friends, welcome to TechWorld. Today I am with a new topic, a very interesting topic actually, how you can make a HTTP call by using REST client. So let's have a look. So I have already created a project in my workspace that is Spring Boot with REST API call. And I have defined a controller class that is my API controller. Inside this API controller, I have created an endpoint like employees and I have a dummy API endpoint. That is, you can see over here the URL, that is my dummy API endpoint. So I want to call this API by using REST client. So let's see how we can do it. So let's declare the REST client, REST template equal to new REST template. So your REST client REST template object is declared. Then you just need to call this API by using this REST template. Control C, REST template, then dot. That will definitely get request. So you need to call get for object. Then you should pass this URL over here, and you will declare the string class inside this, because it is going to return us a string response type. So this is the response. So let's return this response. That's it. It's very simple to call. It's very simple to call this endpoint URL by using REST template. So let's run the application. You can see our Tomcat is started now. Let's check that endpoint point whether this URL is working or not. So localhost colon 300 /employees/employees. Let's hit enter. Let's see what happened. You can see over here that will return all the employees list by calling this endpoint URL. That means this endpoint URL gives us the response like all the employee lists. So it's very simple to call this API by using the REST template client. But most of the time in our real world project, we face the difficulties to make an API call when we have the body and the header we need. We need the body and header things to call this API. So how we can achieve it? Let's see. So I am using another endpoint. To make a API call. Get complete data. Okay. Get complete data. Then I am defining a method get_details here. Then, so I need an endpoint to get the company data. So I need a API endpoint like string URL. And I need this URL actually. You can see over here, I have a API endpoint, this one. So this API endpoint, this is the full contact country API endpoint, which will return the company details by taking its domain name. Okay. So to call this API, we need a header and a body part. In header, that is all defined in the API documents that we don't need to worry about. That is, in the header, it will accept the content type, that is application/JSON. And then the authorization key, it will take bearer plus the API key. So you need to have a API key with us to call this API. So the header is set now, and in the then we need a REST client to call this API. So REST template object is declared over here. Then in the body part, you have to here I am using a JSON object. You can take a map also and put the domain name. Here I am putting the domain name like facebook.com. So I need the details of this facebook.com domain. So then you need to add this body and the header inside a HTTP entity request. After that, you can see over here, I am calling this API by using the exchange method of REST template. So inside this exchange method, let's see, the parameters are URL, and to call this API, you need a post request, the HTTP method dot post request, then the request here, the request is your headers and the body. Then it will returns us a response like string class. So in this, I have to pass the string dot class. So after that, to get the response, you need to write response entity dot get body. That will return us the response. So here it's a error like, okay, API key. I have not defined the API key of this endpoint URL. So let's quickly get that API key. So I have stored this API key in my application dot properties file for the safety purposes. So let's call this API key over here. App inside my app, I have stored API underscore key. Okay, then add the API key. This is the process how you can get the parameter from the properties file. This by using this value tag app.api key and string API key. Now this API key is available inside this controller class. You can see over here the error is gone. Now restart the server and let's see what happened. Okay, the server is restarted. Then go to the browser. And get the endpoint to get the company data. Get company data. Let's see what happens. You can see over here, we have given the domain name like Facebook. Then the, all the details of the Facebook is here. So see, this endpoint URL returns us all the complete details by taking its domain name and the header. It took two parameters, that is content type and the authorization key. Okay, so you can see it's very simple to call API by using REST client, REST template. So we are, I am giving here actually two examples. One is without any header and body, another is with header and body. So I hope you like this. And if you want, I can give my GitHub link of this project in the description box. You can download it. Thank you. Thanks for watching. If you like, then please do subscribe.